When I come home from sea, to the countryside I flee, for a visit to my old grandfather's farm. There I spied a pretty maid, a-laying in the shade. She was winding up a little ball of yarn. And the blackbird and the thrush, they sang out from every bush, keep your hand upon your little ball of yarn. And the blackbird and the thrush, they sang out from every bush, keep your hand upon your little ball of yarn. A pretty maid was she, as she lay there in the lee, and the scene, it was so quiet and so calm. I dropped down where she lay, and unto her did say, let me wind up your little ball of yarn. And the blackbird and the thrush, they sang out from every bush, keep your hand upon your little ball of yarn. And the blackbird and the thrush, they sang out from every bush, keep your hand upon your little ball of yarn. Oh, no, kind sir, says she, you're a stranger unto me, though to foreign gals you may possess some charm. So, sailor, sail away, and come back some other day, to help me wind my little ball of yarn. And the blackbird and the thrush, they sang out from every bush, keep your hand upon your little ball of yarn. And the blackbird and the thrush, they sang out from every bush, keep your hand upon your little ball of yarn. I gazed into her eyes, and I took her by surprise, not intending to do her any harm. Because the blackbird and the thrush, they sang out from every bush, keep your hand upon your little ball of yarn. 10 weary months had passed, ere I saw that girl at last, and she went by with a baby on her arm. But she didn't know 'twas me, a sailor home from sea, who had wound up her little ball of yarn. And the blackbird and the thrush, they sang out from every bush, keep your hand upon your little ball of yarn. And the blackbird and the thrush, they sang out from every bush, keep your hand upon your little ball of yarn.